Murder Kills People is currently airing its second season on Lifetime, and the show has upped the stakes big time. Day and Mary are back for another round, but tensions have been high between them so far this season. Hollywood Life spoke exclusively with Richard Short about Day in season 2. Day is fresh out of prison, and the experience has added a level of maturity he didn't have before. For Richard, it's been a real treat to see that Day matured emotionally post-prison. In addition, Richard will be starring as acting legend Richard Burton in the play Cleo, written by Pulitzer Prize-winning author Lawrence Wright. The play, directed by Bob Balaban, will explore the tumultuous love affair between Richard Burton and the iconic Elizabeth Taylor. You can see Richard and Cleo from April 6th to April 29th at the Alley Theater's Hubbard Theater in Houston, Texas. Day and Mary have had their fair share of conflict early on this season. Will that continue? Richard Short, I think it's fairly obvious that ultimately they're very great, closely bonded friends, so fate, destiny, whatever it may be, is going to drive them back together again. They just have this incredible platonic love for each other that's going to make sure Day is there for her when she needs him most. Day just got out of prison and he helped this 21-year-old not take this leap and take his own life. Do you think prison has given Day a new perspective or outlook on what he and Mary are doing? Richard Short, absolutely. He didn't react in prison to become violent or more criminal. He evolved. He matured emotionally. Now he's got a level head, now he's this guy who can see it from an outsider's perspective. He is still a compassionate man. He still wants to do this for the right reasons and simply not make decisions on people's behalf but just give them the right to die. Because of that, he sees things a little more level-headed than Mary does because she's getting herself into a tizzy because of the extracurricular shenanigans and domesticity getting muddled up. For Day, because he's a loner and single man, he's able to view it more as a referee. I think that's great. You mentioned the relationship with Joshua, who was a lovely actor, Andre Day Kim. I'd send him some songs and things like that to sort of listen to, and we developed a bit of a relationship specifically off camera. We were wondering where to pitch because it's such an oddball relationship. Everyone on set kept calling us the odd couple, a terminally ill guy who's far too young to be experiencing what he is, and then there's Day who's just a mess anyway. Yet they're the only two people who can open up to each other. Day doesn't have that parental bone in his body, so he doesn't feel the necessity to censor himself around Joshua. Likewise, Joshua speaks to Day the same way. He calls Day out on his flaws. It's brilliant. So it's really odd, but because of that, I noticed one of the fans on Twitter this week, you start to see a more fatherly side of Day. You see a paternal streak in him. That's all a part of the maturity that I appreciated. I thought that relationship was one of the big moments in season 2 for me. Is Grady's sister going to continue to cause problems for Day and Mary? Well, what do you think? She's a spicy little ginger thrown into the mix. Obviously, it was easy for her to lure Day into that trap. She's smart. It takes something to replace Grady, because I really do think he was interesting and nefarious in all the right ways. He questioned every choice he made, but in a good way. He also felt they were justified, which was great. You started feeling sorry for this evil drug lord. The show does handle a very controversial topic, assisted suicide. What has the reaction been like from fans? Richard Short, well, the fan reaction has been, from what I've heard, is universally wonderful, very praiseworthy, indeed. People have been effusive in their praise. A lot of people have actually appreciated that we're talking about such a subject matter. The fan reaction has been wonderful and great. You're starring as Richard Burton in the Alley Theater production of Cleo. Did you feel any pressure at all taking on such an iconic figure? Richard Short, enormous pressure. The story of Richard Burton and Elizabeth Taylor caps almost all other stories. When talking about celebrity culture, they started it off. We got paparazzi because of these people. He's known for his deep baritone voice, his wonderfully rich way of speaking, and spinning yarns to reel people in, which was a defense mechanism and the bravado built up from growing up in a Welsh mining town. As I learn more and more about him and watch films and read books every single day, the weird thing about playing someone real is that I was reminded by Bob Balaban, our director, that he and I both knew Sybil Williams, Richard's wife, when he started shooting Cleopatra with Elizabeth Taylor. She passed away about 4 or 5 years ago, but she was running theater in Sag Harbor on Long Island. I developed a relationship and totally forgot all about it. I refer to Sybil in the play. She's my wife. She's not seen but she's referred to many times and is a big cause of contention. I suddenly realized that I knew this woman and it was frightening.